The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 7th chapter, text 27 through 30, and 8th chapter, text 1 through 4, given by His Divine Grace,
A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in September of 1966 in New York.
Janaram Punna Karmaram Te Dandamahane Mukta Bhajanti Mang Dirabhrata. This verse we have been discussing last day. Dandamaha, Dandamaha, this duality, that you have got different interests, I have got different interests. This is called Dandamaha. Your interest is clashing with my interest. This is illusion. This illusion can be removed only by this Krishna consciousness. Therefore the Lord says that jisam antagatam papam. Papam means sin. So, sin, we commit sins out of ignorance. Our sinful nature is due to ignorance. Just like a person who does not know the laws of the state, he commits something which he does not know, but he is captured, he is arrested under the law. Similarly, all kinds of sins we perform, it is due to ignorance. And ignorance is no excuse at the same time. Suppose a child does not know that fire burns, but the child catches fire. The fire is so cruel that it is not excuse. The laws of fire will act even on the child. The child is innocent or ignorant. Innocence is also sometimes ignorance, due to ignorance. We sometimes praise the quality of child, the ignorance. But that child, when grown up, becomes a vicious man. So this ignorance or innocence, they are not very good qualities. So jisam antagatam papam. Papam means sin. One who has been completely free from the reactions of sinful acts. Antagatam papam. Janaram punna karmanam. Are those persons who are simply engaged in activities of piety. Say, those people, dandamaha nirmukta, they can become free from this duality of interest. That means one who becomes Krishna conscious, he has no distinction between one person to another. He has no distinction. Oh, this is Indian, this is American, this is Chinese, this is Russian. No. He transcends this. By Krishna consciousness, we can transcend this material consciousness of different interests. We have no other interest except realization of ourselves. But because due to our ignorance, we have created our different interests, and you are committing sins and breaking the laws of nature, and therefore you are gradually, by and by, becoming more and more entangled in this materialism. So the Lord says that one who has surpassed this material nature and ignorance, they can become free from this conception of duality and bhajante ma and becomes a perfect devotee of myself. That means, in other words, one who becomes perfectly Krishna consciousness, he becomes liberated from this conception of duality or illusion of duality. He becomes a perfect man. Jara marana mokshaya. Now, one can question, why this perfection is required? What is the necessity of perfection? Because there are people mostly under the spell of the modes of nature of ignorance. Therefore, they do not know the value of Krishna consciousness. They can inquire, yes, what is the use of becoming Krishna consciousness, Krishna conscious, and become free from this conception of duality? What is the use? Lord Krishna replied that question. Why? Jara marana mokshaya mam asitta jagant jatanti je te brahma tad vidhu krishnam adhyatma parma chakilam. This is necessary for you to become this Krishna conscious, to adopt this life of Krishna consciousness. Why? Because jara marana mokshaya, in order to get out of the misery of jara. Jara means old age, invalidity. And jara marana, marana means death. Due to ignorance, we forget the miseries of death, the miseries of invalidity or old age. We think, now we are young, young man, young woman. We don't care for what is old age or what is death. Let us enjoy. We forget. A man who is not in ignorance, he has always in his view that this material life is full of miseries because there is birth, there is death, there is old age, and there is disease. We, materialists, don't take into consideration that birth, death, disease and old age are the greatest miseries of our life. Due to our ignorance. But this ignorance has to be removed if one has to become out of these classes of birth, death, old age and disease. This is not possible to remove by the so-called material science. Material science cannot remove this misery. They can remove temporary, something artificially, some of our miseries, just like that feeling, little warm, if the room had been air-conditioned, we could feel some comfort. That is temporary. But our ultimate miseries are these four things, jara, marana, moksha. Jara means old age, and birth, death. The Lord Sri Krishna says, jara marana mokshaya mama sitta. If one has to have the ambition for getting out of these classes of birth, death, old age and disease, then one, if is intelligent enough, then jara marana mokshaya mama sitta, under Krishna consciousness, if one attains his life living activity. Activities there must be. We cannot stop. So long we have got this body, or we have no body, that is activity. We are acting. Every living soul is active by nature. But that activity should be coordinated, not there. The activity should be in Krishna consciousness. So jara marana mokshaya maam asrita jatanti je. Jatanti means one who endeavors. In that way, te brahma. They are actually brahma. Brahma means they are transcendental, in transcendental state. Te brahma tad vidu krishnam. Or they can understand what is the meaning of brahma or the transcendental. Transcendence. Te brahma tad vidu krishnam adhyatma karma chakilam. They understand what is brahma and their work, their activities are also brahma. Now, there are two classes of transcendentalists. One class of transcendentalists, that's like the impersonalists, they want to stop activities. They think like that, that when one becomes one with the transcendent, then their activities stop. But actually, from the Bhagavad Gita, we find that te krishnam udhyatman karma chakilam. Their activities are not stopped, but the quality of the activity is changed. Brahma, the quality of activities become transcendental. Karma chakilam, akhilam. Whatever he does in Krishna consciousness, whatever he does, that becomes Brahma or transcendental. That means free from the contamination of the three modes of material nature. Therefore, as he becomes free from the contamination of the three modes of material nature, therefore he is not going to have next body of this material nature. Next body he is not going to have material. The same example, just if you put an iron rod into the fire, it becomes gradually the fire, the nature of fire, the iron rod attains. So when it is red hot and there is no possibility of it being the iron, but it is fire. So by our activities in Krishna consciousness, we become free from the contamination of these three modes of material nature, and thus at the end we become purely spiritual, transcendental. Here it is said, sadhi bhuta di devam mam sadhi jagdancha je vidu prayana kale pi cha mante vidu yutta chetasa. One who understands the science of Krishna consciousness, sa adibhutam, adidaivam, so even at the time of his death, he remains steady in that Krishna consciousness, and therefore his next birth is not in this material world, but in the spiritual world. Now, next chapter, Krishna inquires, Arjuna inquires, what is this adibhutam, adidaivam, adijagyam? These three questions are being posed by Arjuna. Arjuna was, kinta brahma kim adhyatmam kim karma purushottama adibhutancha kim proktam adhidaivam kim uchyate. Now, these are technical terms. What are these technical terms? First technical term is brahma. What is brahma? Arjuna's question is, first, what is Brahma? Then next question is, what is Adhyatma? What is Adhyatma? Spirit. Then next question is Adibhutam. Adibhuta means, what is these material elements? And Adijagya, what is super soul? And at the time of death, what is the perception of these three things? Very complicated question. Very complicated question. Adhyatma Brahma, Adhyatma Adibhuta, and Adijagya, and Adidaiva. So, Krishna is answering one on each gradually. See, Bhagavanuvasa means Lord Krishna. He is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. He is replying. See, Bhagavanuvasa. What is that? Na asaraṁ paramaṁ brahma sabhāva adhyātma ucchati. Aksaraṁ paramaṁ brahma. Now, aksaraṁ means infallible. And paramaṁ means supreme. And brahma means indestructible. Brahma. Indestructible or which is eternal, that is called Brahma. Now, aksaraṁ paramaṁ brahma. Paramaṁ brahma. Now, eternal, we are eternal. This has been explained in the second chapter of Bhagavad Gita. Nahannate hannamāne sarīre. We do not die even after the destruction of this body. So we are Brahma. Brahma means indestructible and eternal. Some matter may be indestructible sometimes, but not eternal. Matter is not eternal. Therefore, two things are to be understood about Brahma. Indestructible and eternal. So, as we have several times explained, that we are all Brahma, but we are part and parcel of the Brahma. Now, here it is said that Paramang Brahma, the Supreme Brahma. The Supreme Brahma means one who does not come into this material contamination. He is called Supreme Brahma. The impersonalist school, they do not distinguish between these two Brahmas. They say Brahma is one. This individual Brahma, this conception of individual Brahma is Maya, illusion. That is their doctrine. But according to Vaishnava doctrine, they do not accept this. Their question is, if Brahma is supreme, then how he comes in contact with the Maya? A supreme cannot be under the subordination of anything else. If something is under subordination, he cannot be supreme. He cannot be supreme. That is their argument. Therefore, the Brahma who comes under the clutches of this material energy, that Brahma is not the Supreme Brahma. And that is accepted in the Vedic literature. Nitya nityanam chetana chetanana. There are eternals, but out of the eternals, there is one Supreme Eternal. Nitya. Nitya means singular number. And nityanam means plural number. The plural number, Iya, plural number. Nitya Nityana. Chetana. Chetana means living. I am also living. God is also living. He is also a living being. Like us. But he He's listening to me. It's like this. Eka bhavanam vidadhati kamat. That eka, that singular number, Brahma. He maintains all these plural numbers, Brahma. Therefore, this plural number Brahma, this Jivatma, this living entities, they are supported by the Supreme Brahma, Bhagavan. Just as government and citizens, now together there is a nation, but government supports the citizens. Similarly, Parabrahma and ordinary living entities, Brahma, simple Brahma, they are qualitatively one. But the Supreme Brahma supports all other Brahma. So Aksharam Paramam Brahma. Aksharam means that the Supreme Brahma, or the Supreme Personality of God. Sabhama Dhyatam Uchyati. Sabhavam, this quality, they are called Abhyati. Bhuta Bhava Taro Visarga Karma Sangita. And the activities out of these three qualities of material nature, they are called karma. What? Adhibhutam Charo Bhava. Adhibhutam. The material energy is chara. Chara means destructive. Charo Bhava. Purusascha Didaivatam. And the living soul, he is called Adhidaiva. Adhijagdahameva Atra Dehi Diyavita. Now we have several times explained in this meeting that there are two birds, the individual soul and the super soul that are sitting in this tree of this body. So the super soul is called Adhijagdah. These are all the technical names you can remember. And the super soul is called Adhijagya. And the soul is called Adhibhuta. Now, Krishna says, these technical terms, of course, one should know. But it requires very long description. We have to give our attention separately for understanding. Generally, we can take up. Now, the real fact is that why these things have to be known. Now, Lord Krishna says, Antukalesa mameva smaran mukta kalivaram japrayati samadabhavam jati nastatra samshaya. Now, here is a critical point. The critical point is antakala. Now, if you go on with Krishna consciousness, the ultimate result of Krishna consciousness, what is the ultimate result? The ultimate result is described here. The antakala, at the time of your death, when it's called antakala, now end everything, all our activities, all these proprietorship, everything is now end. Not end, it is just going to, just at the verge of your point of death. Antakale cha mameva. Mameva, Krishna says mam. And to me, Krishna. So therefore, one who is always constantly in Krishna consciousness, naturally, at the time of his death, he'll think of Krishna. This is a practice. This is a practice. Just like that king Kulasekha, he has got many nice verses about his devotional service. And in one verse he describes about his position. He says, Krishna tadiya padapam kajapanjarantam paddaiva visatumi manasa raja hansa prana priyana samai kapubhata pittai. kanthavarodhanavidhau smaranankataste. Because at the time of death, my dear Krishna, I do not know what will be my position, because at that time all the functions of my body will be stopped, and naturally there will be a block in my throat or the cuff. At the time of death, one who has seen a dying man, he will see there is cuff in this kantha, in this throat, in the channel throat. So he prays, at the time of death, kanthavarodhanavidhau kapavittabhatu. By the derangement of the bodily function, when kapha will choke up my throat, then how I shall be able to chant? Because I am now healthy. I am now chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. But at that time, how I shall be able to chant? So therefore, while I am chanting now in good health, please let me die immediately so that I can die chanting. That is the prayer. But because that is the ultimate examination. Here it is stated. Antakale cha mameva smaran mukta kalevaram. Just kalevaram. Kalam is this body. And when becomes free from this body, he gets out of the body, and at the very same time he remembers Krishna, then one who passes this body, life in this way, ta prayati, sa madhavam jati. Madhavam jati means he at once attains the nature of Krishna, eternity, blissful, and knowledge. This is the advantage of Krishna consciousness. Because at the time of death, whatever you practice now in your healthy life, that will be just like a sleep. We dream of the things of our activities. Similarly, this death is also kind of dream. Death is a dream. Death is sleep, sleeping. Death is nothing but sleeping for 7 months. That's all. Sleeping for 7 months. That is called death. Just like in the operation table, one becomes unconscious for 1 hour, half an hour, and then he comes to his consciousness. Again he comes to the same point. So similarly, death is nothing but to remain practically unconscious for 7 months. That's all. This body is left, and we enter into a particular womb of mother, and just to develop another body, it takes about 7 months. Then after 7 months, when the body is fit, then our consciousness comes back. Then we want to come out of the womb, and at the 10th month we come out. So that is a very miserable condition. That is the miserable condition of birth. But one who leaves his body in Krishna consciousness, antakale, at the point of death, Krishna says, japrayati, who leaves his body in this way, sa madhavam jati, he at once attains the perfection like me, like my nature. His nature is transcendental, therefore one attains at once transcendental. Jati, nāsyatra saṃsaya. These things have to be taken. Nāsyatra saṃsaya, there is no doubt about it. Now if we believe Krishna as the supreme authority, if we believe him, then we can adopt it. And there is no question of disbelieving him, because all great souls, all great scholars, and all great spiritualists. Arjuna, say the example of Arjuna, he's not an ordinary man, he belongs to the royal order, and he's a great fighter, great general, and He is taking instruction from Krishna. If Arjuna has taken instruction from Krishna, Ramanujaja has taken accepted Krishna as the Supreme, his Sankaracharya has accepted the Krishna as Supreme, and holy Acharya Lord Chaitanya has accepted Krishna as the Supreme, then what is the difficulty of my understanding about his greatness? Mahajana Jena Gatasya Pantha. Just like when you go to the market, if we see that everyone is purchasing at the same time, then I think, undoubtedly this is exactly right. Let me purchase at this price. The doubt is gone at once. Because I see several persons, they are accepting at the price. So it is right price. That is the standard. Mahajana Jena Gatasya Pantha. The Shastra says that knowledge, because our receptive power of knowledge is very limited. We are not perfect. Our senses are not perfect. Therefore, whatever knowledge is acquired by these blurred senses, they cannot be perfect. The direction is therefore tarko apatishtha. If you want to reach to the ultimate conclusion simply by arguments and speculation, that is not possible. Because argumentative power is a special gift. Suppose you can argue very nicely, that's all, I cannot. But somebody may come, he is more powerful in arguments, he can defeat you. So don't depend on your speculative function or arguments. Don't depend. They are all imperfect. Tattva pratishtha. These are the directions of higher authority. So tattva pratishtha sutayo vivinna. Sutra means scriptures. If you take scriptures, different scriptures there are, and one scripture may differ from another scripture, so that is also very difficult to find out the real truth, transcendence from the scriptures. So, tattva pratishtha sutayo vibhinnya, nasur munijyasya mita matana bhinnam. And so far philosophy is concerned, each and every philosopher is different from the other philosopher. One philosopher is putting some theory, another philosophy is putting another doctrine or theory. So we are puzzled. Which of them has to be accepted? Sutayo vibhinnya, naso munijyasya, because in the mundane philosophers, mundane scholars, they want to give his own interpretation of everything. That is their habit. They don't accept the interpretation of the higher authorities. They want, each and every one of them want to become the higher authorities. So our, this principle, this devotional principle is not like that. We don't pose ourselves as the higher authority. We just try to follow the higher authority. We don't pose ourselves. We will never say that in my opinion it should be like this. Oh, what opinion I have got? What value I have got in of my opinion? What is my value? I am a blunt man, I cannot acquire any knowledge perfectly, and what is the use of my opinion? So this is the line. Krishna consciousness is they do not accept anything which is not authorized by the higher personality. But in the material world, you'll find one philosopher is putting one doctrine, another philosopher is putting another doctrine, and they're differing with one another. So you cannot conclude what is real thing. Nāsuri munijyasya matangana bhinyam dharmasya tattam nihitam guhāyam. Therefore, the truth, real truth, is lying in the very confidential part of your body. Then what is to be done? The best thing is Mahajana Jena Gatastha Pantha. You just try to follow the higher authorities. So Krishna is the higher authority. Krishna is the higher authority. If we accept him and follow this instruction, and if we believe him, then we get perfection. There's no doubt about it. Of course, this philosophical question as Deepika, it may not be very interesting, but they are to be understood. Actually, if we want to get out of ignorance, these ropes are meant for driving our ignorance. And as we become out of the ignorance, so we become free from this material entanglement. But at the present stage, people are not so intelligent that they can follow. Therefore, this Sankirtan movement is the best. Everyone can take part. And Hare Krishna is chanting there, undoubtedly. We discuss this Bhagavad Gita only for understanding that we are not blindly following a principle. It is a science. It is based on philosophy and science. But we have made the process easy, that's all. By following great solvent personalities. But it is not that, it is a blind following. It is based on philosophy and science, this Krishna consciousness. So if anyone wants to understand on the basis of philosophy and science, oh, we have got ample philosophy and science on this planet. But if you accept it, then it is the same thing. The acceptance is required. If you directly accept it, suppose a fire, if fire you accept it at once, or you accept fire by scientific study, what is fire, what is the quality, what is this, God, you can understand scientifically fact. But either you understand it scientifically or philosophically, or you touch it directly, the action is the same. The action is the same. A child without knowing the science of fire, physical constitution of fire, if it touches the fire will act. And then a great scientist who has physical knowledge of this fire, if he touches also fire, he will get peace also. But, so Krishna consciousness is so nice that if you accept without understanding any philosophy or science about it, this is relaxed. But if you want to understand it through philosophy and science, you have got time to stop in the Bhagavad Gita. These are the... Now Krishna concludes, of course I shall conclude this portion after reading one verse. Janjana Bhapi Smaran. Now Krishna has said that at the last point of your death, if you are in full Krishna consciousness, then your next promotion is to the equal status of Krishna. Madhavam. In the same nature. Why? Now the truth is, Janjana Bhapi Smaran Bhavam Tajatanti Kalivaram Tan Samiva Aiti Kauntiya Sadasad Bhava Bhavita. The nature's law is that if you have practiced under certain condition of life, and at the end of death, if you think of that life, then your next verse. This next verse is means carrying the idea of this birth to the next one. You are changing simply body. Then, suppose you are poet, you are a thoughtful poet. Now when you change your body, are you still remain a poet? By changing your body, it does not become something else. So that the thought is the real thing. That will carry you to the other body. This is gross body, and there is subtle body. The subtle body is mind, ego and intelligence. So when you give up this gross body, the subtle body carries me to another gross body. another prospect. But when you become on the same level of Krishna consciousness, then your this subtle body also cannot act. You directly go in spiritual body to Krishna. So we shall discuss this point next. Now if there is any question, we can ask.